All right, well, it's the next to the last day, and I am with John Nugent. We are in his dad's deer shanty.
We're in the tree hut.
The tree hut.
Not attached to a tree.
Yeah.
it's fantastic.
We've got the heater going, old school Coleman here, and see if we can see some deer come out into a food plot right here this morning. No deer this morning. He even sat under the food plot, but
it was a bust.
Nothing. So
we saw a cat.
Yeah, we saw a cat.
So and an owl. A cool owl. I go up to the stand.
My stand, and this evening Luke Sweeney will be up. We might put him in the other shanty, and we're going to try to doe hunt this evening. So we'll see what happens. We're up in the lower deer shanty where the twins shot their doe. And what are you using, John?
Same gun as always. Tried and true. Remington 760 Game Master chambered in 30-06. John actually just put a Facebook post up asking about... What's your favorite deer rifle? And if we're talking strictly Pennsylvania, I had to comment. I can't help myself. I said, a Remington 760 Game Master from the 60s and the 70s. I think they started making them in like 1957. I think they discontinued them in 1981, maybe 84. And the most common calibers were the 270, the 30-06. 243 is semi-common. My dad has one in 243, and I think that the McCalls do. Brennan McCall has one in 243. But the 308, I heard, is actually one of the ones that's harder to get. I'd love to have a 760 Game Master in 308, but... Like I said in that comment, those calibers are the deer hunting, typical PA deer hunting calibers. And I said that I think a Game Master is better than any lever action out there. Maybe less than the 45-70 government. I'm a big fan of that one. But as far as the 760 goes, it's a pump. And to track a deer that might be trotting through the woods or one that's across a field, you can stay on target better in a 760 Game Master than you can with a bolt. I've hunted deer with a bolt gun. I've never hunted deer with a lever, but I've shot plenty of lever actions, and I don't know, something about the pump. You can,
yep.
It's the best, as far as I'm concerned, it's the best PA deer rifle.
Nice.
And 30-06 is the best.
You're with Ron.
Yeah, with Ron for sure.
Oh, we got some.
Oh, that's loud.
Yeah, I see. No, those look like hens. Maybe a Jake and a hen.
Wait, maybe eight. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Now, Luke is up now, and he's going to go to the lower stand where John and I were just at, where we saw all the turkeys. He's going to be going for a doe. Taking John up to the other deer shanty. And we're going to try to see if we can get some doe. Okay, Sweeney is going up into that stand. We're going up to the other one. We're in the stand, ready to go. We got a doe coming out down here. Wait, there's more than one. There's another one coming behind it, so that we have less. Close that window. We'll open this one. Yeah, there's another one in the back coming out.
There's two more. gonna turn. Which one are you gonna shoot? The one that's moving around.
Yeah, I want the other one to come out. I want to see how big it is.
Okay, just wait until I move. If that other one turns, just wait. She's coming back around. Just being spooky, they're gonna come in. We just gotta take our time.
If that big one walking straight at me comes out,
she's watching if she turns because of that one behind her.
Yeah.
Saw the hair fly.
Safety back on.
All right, let's let me look at the footage here.
You have him on video, or you have him? The walkie-talkie turned up.
Yeah. Okay. I do. Yeah, it's in my pocket. We heard a shot. We don't know if Sweeney shot because we had all the windows closed, but it was close. But Sweeney's walkie-talkie's almost dead. There's the stand.
Because we didn't plan well.
Yeah, we did not plan well.
Yeah. And here's where it's scuffed away.
Yeah.
And here's the hair.
Yep, there's the hair. Well, she just kept running straight across.
Did she run straight across?
I thought she cut down. You think so? I tried to. There's a kicked up right there. We gotta find blood sooner or later. There's a buck scrape right there. Did you find blood?
Right there.
Yeah. First drop of blood right there. He's not bleeding real good, but there's definitely dead deer down in here somewhere.
fall, I saw it run straight down into the woods.
Oh, okay. Well, that's probably where she went. So it took us a little while. Right there's where she come into the woods and going on some trails. We thought she went down the hill, but she cut went sideways. You can kind of see the dirt kicked up right there.
Oh.
Now that might have been Sweeney.
That was close.
That was close too.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. So just keep following that. She's got to be laying in here somewhere. She jumped over this log. Right over here. Look. Right there. Sweeney says he got a doe.
Oh, it's going. It's right
there. Oh, I do. I see your deer. We will be down in a minute.
He said he shot a doe?
I think he said he shot a doe.
Of course, he had to run on the other side of the line.
It goes on the other side of the
hog.
It is a big...
It's a hog.
Oh my word, that is a big deer.
And it's over the brush.
This could be a fun one to get out.
This is the second hog doe I've shot this year. I'm out of tons of meat, because the last one I had a pound.
Oh, yeah.
She's a biggin. Oh, look at the skull on that doe.
Yeah. I don't think she's as old as Andrew's last year, but the size is very good. That's exit right there.
Yeah.
Yep. It looks a little bit far back, but it was quartering towards.
Well, it was.
It actually didn't even run.
It didn't run.
Really, it ran in a half circle.
There's
right there. Yeah, right behind the shoulders. Tight as you can get right behind the shoulder. But that's a big deer. Congrats, John.
Well, thanks, bud.
Yeah.
Appreciate you taking me up in your hut.
Yeah, no problem.
We didn't even need to use the heat.
No, we didn't have to use the heat today. Yeah,
it was, the windows open.
It was getting up to 50 degrees, but it's cooling down tonight. But yeah, that makes three deer out of each deer shanty. Out of eight deer killed on the property, six were killed out of both of the deer shanties this year. So.
Well, you know what I can do.
What?
This. Don't need that anymore.
Nope. All right, that's awesome.
So Sweeney shot a doe?
Yeah. There's John with his 2020 number two doe. That's a pretty good sized one. Big old floppy eared doe, big mature doe, one of them sneaky doe. We think they got bumped from some other hunters because I don't think they were coming into the food plot to eat. Kind of looked like they were trying to go up into the pines up behind us, and they were really being cautious when they come out into the open. But yeah, that's a big, big doe.
Look at the head on that thing.
Yeah.
It's a big deer. I'm going to eat good for 2021.
Yeah, you are. All right, congrats.
Well, thanks, man. Appreciate it.
We'll go check out Sweeney, see if he got one now.
Yeah, now we're headed down there.
Yep. We drove the deer out. Start gutting the deer because we wanted to gut it up out of the woods so we had a little bit more light. And I'm going to run down here and see how Sweeney's doing because he's only about 300 yards away. So, see if he got one. All right, I see Sweeney. He's out of the stand. I see him down here. See what he got. All right. Oh, lots of hair. Lots and lots of hair.
The string continues through here.
Where'd you see the deer run after he shot? Yeah.
Right up to here. It boogied into here.
Ran to the right?
Yeah.
How far did you make it from here? This is the last spot you.
I've been trying to mark with sticks.
Trying to mark blood. All right, well, we'll keep going, see if we can find it. Definitely hit it, so.
I hit it.
Okay. How many were there?
Two.
We finally found John's deer because it was quartering two, so it didn't bleed as much, so it was a little bit of a hard track job.
Mine was
Square.
Square. Like, perfect.
I'd be right behind.
Well, it should be right up here then. All right. Okay, we got first blood. We're following the tracks, just like John's. Looks like it went right out through there. Well, there looks like there's two different tracks right here. So you go that way, I'm gonna go this way. It looks like I see some. Maybe I'm not. Maybe it did go your way. Got it? All right. That's a big deer too. You and John just both shot big doe. Congrats.
Thank you. We found a great amount of hair, one droplet of blood, and then just followed the rustled leaves.
So your deer ran about the same distance as John's, maybe, you know, 30, 35 yards tops.
I don't know if you can see what it's laying in.
Oh, yeah. Not as bad as... That's way worse than John's. Yeah, we thought John's was bad. But you don't got a length. You just got to watch for the briars. Yeah. So.
Yeah, this is
alrighty.
Funny Royer stand. Every year you come up here and just clean house.
Yeah. Yep. You guys always do it towards the end of the season.
It's a big doe.
It is a big doe.
So I hit it on
Here's
the other
the
side.
Exit hole.
Yeah.
Right behind the shoulder. Roll it over. And.
No, I hit her like right here.
Yeah, right here. Right there. Yep. Tucked in tight behind the shoulder. Perfect shot. Second doe, 2020 season. Big doe. What were you using?
30-06. Old gun. My pap made this back in the 60s.
Nice. Two 30-06 doe down, big doe. I don't know whose is bigger. They're both big doe. That's the last three doe have been horses taken on the property. It just goes to show there needs to be a lot of doe shot off. You got so many big doe running around. We're still hearing shots right now. There's two shots since I've been talking. They're really laying into them up over the hill. They're running, so.
No, another great year. Two deer down for me. I know we might take a look and see if we get a buck tomorrow morning, but this is a great way to finish the season off. We got one more day left, and it's an amazing season.
Congrats.
Thank you, buddy.
All right, well, Sweeney guts his deer. You know, that's the, I was just telling John, out of the deer shanties that I got, that makes, what, 9 deer shot so far on the property here this year? 2 buck. The rest were all doe and antlerless deer, and they were all shot out of the shanties except for 3 of them. No. 2 of them, all but 2. So that's pretty good.
That's a big one, for sure. Bow, show. Once you get it up in there.
Yeah.
Oh, it's good. Send it.
Your deer smeared most of the blood that I left from my deer off my tailgate.
Well,
as far as I'm concerned, that's a win.
Mine blows his out of the water. Usually this is a conversation we have Saturday at 5:30.
Okay, drag them both, put them butt to butt. You gotta put them butt to butt. We can't tell just by one looking like it's in front of the other one.
Man, yeah. Them are two big doe though. Oh, we were dragging mine out. The exit wound got stuck on a chunk of a pine tree and like brought us to a hole. I'm like, oh, hold on.
This is usually what happens. The last day. In the weaning minutes.
Yeah, but now tomorrow we're both going.
We all have deer.
And we both have 2 doe. So now we're trophy hunting.
If you told me those things were twins, I'd believe it.
Yeah, I honestly am thinking that that's the other deer that was with your deer.
The 2 doe that we had walk out, Sweeney, in front of us with a fawn. The 1 doe. They both looked identical, and then because I wanted to wait. Because it was the one, first one was giving us a look, it's staring straight at us.
Yeah.
And then it was stomping, doing, you know, annoying doe stuff. And it went around the back side. Well, the other one came out and stared at us for maybe 5 minutes. And then finally, when it turned, I said, John, the minute this deer gives us a shot, turn, boom.
See, mine was.
They looked identical in the size.
I was looking out this side of the stand, and the deer came from right over here. And I was like, oh no, I'm out of the skidded back. Deer's walking away from me, and I'm like, I'm gonna tuck this under the armpit. And then in my scope, this guy walked out, and I was like, much cleaner shot.
So was the other one the same, smaller? Or?
I think it was smaller. I mean, yeah. I was trying to look at like faces and
the
see
the other one.
Knows.
That's
yeah,
because
the
I
other
it.
One that was with your deer was an average sized deer, so it was definitely a younger deer. But yeah, awesome.
All right, John, what are we having for dinner?
These deer, they're four deer steaks that I got. These are from the deer I shot on opening Sunday of rifle season. I said, what a better way to have dinner than deer steaks that I got this season.
Yeah.
And then
nice. We
did potatoes.
And you marinated
them in Italian dressing for like...
Just like we did at Snake Camp.
48 hours. Yep. Right. Those were deer steaks. Those weren't butterfly chops. Those were in tenderloin. Yeah, these are the exact same way that I do deer steaks. Pretty much any time I make myself deer steak. This is all like the Walmart box stuff. Box rice, box broccoli, box potatoes.
Oh, man.
Man, if we had some rails. If we had some rails to go with this, it'd be perfect.
It's super easy to just bring all this stuff up in like packages in my little cooler. You know, when you're doing it for two people, it's a perfect amount.
Sweeney, where's your broccoli?
Well, you know, vegetables are for the week.
Vegetables are for the week. That's a good one.